Hi, I'm Johan. Welcome to my channel. Today we're going to look at the suspension. More correct, the hydraulic for the suspension. When the suspension is working, the oil in this cylinder has to go from this side to that side of the piston. But on this side it's less volume because of the shaft. So that oil has to go into the accumulators. And on the accumulators we have a piston with gas on one side and oil on the other side. I can fill the system by turning off a valve from the steering wheel, from the orbital in the steering wheel, so I can pump it up. And I also have four valves, I can adjust one system at a time. When the oil is coming from the cylinder back to the accumulator, it has to go through those valves here, and they are flow restrictor. And there's one for the inflow and then one for the outflow.
But he was released in 1990 and didn't pass away until 2013. History novel. In the book, the Allies lost universes were actually parallel computers.
In a computer programmed reality. The only clue we have to it is change. Alteration.
The computer program, which is reality, is constantly being updated, and each update is an improvement on the.
I'm restricting my flow with these regulators so I can have a better rebound for the suspension. And there's also a third one. And this one is just a bypass, and I can control them from the inside of the driver compartment. The oil is coming through these 1-inch hoses and going down to the other side. The amount of oil that's over that can't be pushed over to the other side. It has to go somewhere and it's going down to my accumulators. 1 minute later you have oil on one side and you have gas pressure on the other side. And when you're compressing the gas, it wants to push back. But I can also regulate this one. This is an electric regulator, so I can shut off this one, so it only goes in the other one. And I can have it harder in one and softer in the other one.
Even if it's not necessarily a large area overall, because as you can see, again, if Russian forces are pushed. Reporting some success south of Rovertina. Ukrainian forces penetrating both the second defensive line here and penetrating this line here. You want to see more penetration, more control of these defensive areas in Ukrainian hands. And again, into Rovertina, you can see how much work they're going to have to do. Certainly a lot of questions, and a lot of questions about why, when the momentum seems so focused on Verbova, why you would pivot over to this other axis. Anyway, guys, if you have been under a rock the last week, you...
Actual stars and all that sort of stuff. So, that's the plan of attack. It's a new day now, so...
It's just a really nice, kind of quiet, reflective time for me. Have a low and try and do the same myself in a second. Morning, sleepyhead.
Literally just come off watch and had enough time to get my kit off and relax in bed.
Need to let us sleep. With more squally weather approaching on the horizon, along with a big wind shift, it meant we both...
So we've had a bit of a rest, and then I think probably we'll end up in a mesa back up and go back to...
Should explain why we're using the triple reef mainsail instead of the Genoa. Usually when we're sailing downwind in these conditions, our preferred sail plan would be the Genoa on the pole and stowsail wing on wing, without using the mainsail. But we have a problem with that.
Today the wind and the waves are back. They actually came back late yesterday afternoon. We've got regularly sort of 20-25. A bit of a problem last night. I was so tired that I went to bed and on the leeward side, and I figured we hadn't really been.
But this was only a brief respite before the wind.
As a drogue to try and slow down so we're not surfing these waves so much. Matt looked at the forecast this morning, just downloaded the forecast before I came off watch, and it's saying that we're going to have this.
The perfect war. Actually, a clean war, because it was the decisive results were accomplished with so few casualties on both sides, actually, in the first Gulf War. That's their model. They can view that as a clean war. Problem is, he's decapitating his own leadership. You're supposed to be decapitating his any measure or inkling that they could be a threat and target them and remove them.
And John, you've mentioned this term before, a fifth generation warfighter.
I'm not even going to name them because they're really classified, but they're on a much smaller scale. They were not dropping fifth-generation. But that's where all their psychological operations arise from. Microsoft has been identified. Yes, China is meddling in social media to influence elections. It's coming that is visible and demonstrative. It's called our quick strike mine with wing kits. We can actually.
I would have been annoyed if I'd gone and put in there.
Can you see the little spring? Probably hard now.
No, there's actually a little steel.
Oh,
like a spring
end.
Steel
oh,
snap
the
right
there.
There.
Yeah, I see.
So that's what locks it in, really.
Nice. Yeah.
My life to this point has been a lie. It comes and goes.
No, I'm just saying as a general rule, I mean, I'm picturing the Karma Chameleon to look one way, and then I'm going to look up the music video, and maybe they'll have you
and demons be a chameleon, and then maybe there's no karma. I don't know why. Become cultist.
Well, they stretch over time, right?
No, see, the difference is I'll use factory forge or factory bolts. Time after time.
If I push a button inside, I can actually lock out one of the accumulator. The reason I have two accumulators, that's one is for the higher pressure and one is for the lower. When this accumulator is locked out in the front, the truck will launch like this. And if I lock it out in the back, it will actually launch off this, off a jump. So. Hopefully it works. I don't know yet. I'm still missing some parts. I have to have a reducer from 1 inch to 3/8 hydraulic. So I can put a hose between this and this one. So I'm missing the coupling for this one. It's actually a weld on 1 inch coupling. So I have to take them apart again and weld this on. They don't do rams like this small with 1 inch couplings. So I have to make them myself. That's all for this episode. Hope you liked it, and if you did, put down a like or a comment. And if you're new here, why don't you subscribe? It really helps the channel. Would be nice to come over 1,000 subscribers. So I'll see you next time, I guess. Bye.